Hello students, in the last lecture we have discovered about the general characteristics of Kingdom Monera, right? And we came to know about the members of the Kingdom Monera. Basically it consists of the sole member, that is bacteria, but there are certain other members of this group are also, but the main member and the sole of this kingdom is bacteria. Bacteria like other members also, so we will discuss bacteria, means the eubacteria, which is the true bacteria, and the other forms of the bacteria are also like archaebacteria, actinomycetes, spirochetes, cyanobacteria. So we will discuss this in detail. So first I am going to deal with the true bacteria, that is eubacteria. So eubacteria, which is also known as true bacteria और द बैक्टीरिया, जो जनरली बैक्टीरिया जिसके बारे में हम लोग बात करते हैं, तो आई एम गोइंग टू डील अबाउट दिस दैट बैक्टीरिया दैट इज यू बैक्टीरिया और द बैक्टीरिया. सो बैक्टीरिया इज बेसिकली यूनिसेलुलर प्रोकैरियोटिक ऑर्गेनिज्म विच हैज़ नो ओनली मेम्ब्रेनलेस ऑर्गेनल्स विच एंड न्यूक्लियस इज एब्सेंट इंस्टेड the nucleoid is present which is attached with the plasma membrane or the infoldings of the plasma membrane, that is mesosomes, right? Now bacteria ki sabse pehle the bacteria was discovered by the scientist Leon Hogg. He discovered them in the stored rain water and the tartar scraped from the teeth, right? So let's see who let's write down this information. So it was Leon Hogg who for the first time discovered bacteria. And what were the sources? He discovered bacteria in stored rain water and tartar scraped from teeth, right? He give this information in the book The Secrets of Nature by Leon Hogg. He published his discovery in the book Secrets of Nature by Leon Hawk, right? ये जो इन्होंने डिस्कवरी की थी किस बुक में पब्लिश हुआ? सीक्रेट्स ऑफ नेचर बाय लियोन हॉग. एंड ही कॉल दोज ऑर्गेनिजम्स दोज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स बेसिकली बैक्टीरिया इज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज वी कैन नॉट ऑब्जर्व दैम विद द नेकेड आई वी नीड अ माइक्रोस्कोप दैट्स वाई इट इज नोन एज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म सो इट ही कॉल दीज ऑर्गेनिजम्स He did not get the term bacteria. Initially, he called them animalcule, right? Animalcules. Later, another scientist, very popular scientist, is Linnaeus. Linnaeus gave them term vermis. ठीक है? Linnaeus ने इनको term दिया vermis. But the term bacteria was given by scientist F.J. Kohn and Ehrenberg. So who gave the term bacteria? Term bacteria was given by scientist F.J. Kohn and Ehrenberg. These were the two scientists who gave the term bacteria. So right now we are discussing the history. Later there came a scientist Berger who placed this bacteria in the prosophyta group, and he gave his postulate in the book in a book that is the Manual of Determinative Biology. Berger, what he did? BYJU’S placed the bacteria in prosophyta group. ठीक है, उसने बैक्टीरिया को किस ग्रुप में रखा? Prosophyta group. And he wrote a book that is the book of manual of determinative biology. The name of his book is manual of determinative biology, and this book is supposed to be the Bible of bacterial classification. इस बुक को क्या बोलते हैं? It is also known as the Bible of bacterial classification. Right? Now there came the another scientist, that is Joseph Lister. He gave the Lister technique and sterilization technique. Sterilization technique to sterilize the surgical instruments, right? So the another scientist who played role in the history of bacteria was Joseph Lister. Joseph Lister, actually bacho, we do not need to deal all these things in detail. Wherever it is required, we will discuss in detail. So Joseph Lister, he gave the Lister technique. And he also gave the sterilization technique. Sterilization technique for the sterilization of surgical instruments. Right? Then there came another science, another very important scientist in the field of bacteria, that is Robert Koch. Robert Koch was the first scientist who for the first time obtained the pure culture of bacteria, right? Robert Koch ने सबसे पहले बैक्टीरिया का प्योर कल्चर ऑब्टेन किया था. He was the first to obtain pure culture of bacteria. And he also discovered that anthrax, TB and cholera, these are the diseases which are caused by the bacteria. इन्होंने ही बताया कि he discovered that anthrax, TB and cholera, these are the diseases which are caused by the bacteria. Later, Robert Koch, he gave the Koch postulate. And Koch postulate kya hota tha? According to this postulate, it is proposed that the bacteria are the root cause for all the types of the diseases, for the maximum type of the diseases. Basically, according to this Koch postulate, he gave the Koch postulate. It stated the rules to prove that bacteria are causal organism for the disease. ठीक है, so in the Koch postulate there are the rules to prove that bacteria cause diseases. And इसी Koch postulate के लिए ही Robert Koch got the Nobel Prize for this postulate, for giving this postulate. Robert Koch got Nobel Prize, right, for the Koch postulate. But this Koch postulate is not applicable for certain bacteria. In some cases, it is not applicable. And what are those cases? It is not applicable in case of obligate parasites. Jo cause postulate hai, it is not applicable in obligate parasite. For example, mycobacterium, leprae. Mycobacterium leprae. ठीक है? So these are all about the history of the bacteria. Now the study of the bacteria is known as the bacteriology. Bacteriology is the branch of science which deals with the study of bacteria. Bacteria in among with many other organisms, the study of all those microorganisms is done under a special branch of botany biology, that is microbiology. Microbiology is a branch where the study of microorganisms are done. See, it is a branch of biology where the study of microorganisms are performed. Now, after the history, let's see the occurrence or the habitat where they are present. So, bacteria are ubiquitous in nature. They are cosmopolitan in nature. You can find them in anywhere. You can find them in air, in the mountain top, on the mountain top, in the ocean bottom. You can find them in. You can find them in the hot spring of water, in the sulfur, sulfur spring, in the acidic and alkaline water, in the soil, in various type of the surfaces, on the various type of the surfaces. So they are ubiquitous. Bacteria are ubiquitous, right? Now let's see the shape of the bacteria. After discussing shape and of the bacteria, we will shape and the motility of the bacteria, we will discuss the cellular structure. So first I will be dealing with the shape of bacteria. Now bacteria are mainly there are four types. There are on the basis of the shape of mainly there are of four types. First shape is coccus. Okay, coccus shaped bacteria, they are spherical in shape. Coccus bacteria, they are spherical in shape, right? First is coccus bacteria, which are spherical in shape, and they are again of many types. If the this is the shape of the coccus bacteria, if the single bacteria is present, then it is known as monococcus, right? If the bacteria are present in the form of pair, then it is known as diplococcus. When they are present in the form of chain attached with each other side by side, then it is known as streptococcus. When they are present in the form of bunch, when they are present in the form of bunch, like the bunch of grape, is tarike se. When they are present in the form of bunch of grapes, then it is known as staphylococcus. When sometimes they are present in the form of cube, they show the three-dimensional structure, then they are known as sarsini. such shape or bacteria is known as Shastini. ठीक है? तो we can cite one example of coccus bacteria. I am writing it here. Diplococcus. Pneumonia. ये जो bacteria होते हैं, coccus bacteria जो होते हैं, in these bacteria, flagella are always absent. So, such type of bacteria are always non-motile. So here, flagella absent. ठीक है, so such type of bacteria are non-motile bacteria. Due to the absence of flagella, they are non-motile bacteria. Next type of bacteria on the basis of shape is bacillus. Bacillus ka matlab hota hai rod. In Greek, it is its meaning is rod, and these bacteria are rod shaped or cigar shaped, right? Let's see their structure. Kaisa hota hai? Is tarike se jo these are rod shaped bacteria, and sometimes they are cigar shaped bacteria. They are cigar shaped. Theek hai? Now bacillus or rod shaped bacteria are again of many types. When the single rod is present, then it is known as monobacillus. When the two rods are present together like this, then they are known as diplobacillus. When the rods are present in the rod, these bacteria are present in the form of chain, then they are known as streptobacillus. Right? Sometimes these rod shaped bacteria, they are arranged one above the other in the form of a stake. Then in that case they are known as palisade. Then that shape is known as palisade shape. Yahan pe is tarike se they are arranged in the form of stake. Such shape of the rod shaped bacteria is known as palisade shape. Right? Example of this bacteria, coccus ka example maine yahan likha hai, diplococcus pneumoniae. E. coli means Escherichia coli is the bacteria which is mostly studied in the case field of microbiology. Next is bacillus anthracis. B for bacillus anthracis, right? Third type of bacteria on the basis of the shape is spirilla, spiral bacteria. Okay, they are elongated, their shape is elongated and twisted. Let's see their shape. How is this shape? These are the, ठीक है, and at one end flagella are present. So these are elongated and twisted in shape, elongated and twisted form bacteria which are known as spiral bacteria. And one example is spirulum. Volutins. The fourth shape of the bacteria is vibrio or the comma shaped bacteria, also known as comma shaped bacteria. Right? कैसे इनका स्ट्रक्चर होता है? कॉमा आप देखते हो कैसा होता है? This is the, these are the vibrio or comma shaped bacteria. Example, you can cite the example of this bacteria, vibrio cholerae. Now let's see the motility in bacteria. Generally, bacteria are motile or non-motile. If they are motile, they can be moved with the help of the flagellum. So, on the basis of the number of flagellum present over their body, bacteria are again of many types. So, let's see the motility in bacteria and the types of the bacteria on the basis of the flagellum present there. So, motility of bacteria may be, मैंने बताया जैसे कि it may be motile or may be non-motile, and if it is motile then it is motile due to the presence of flagellum. Now on the basis of the flagellum, bacteria are of different types. Let's see the types of the bacteria on the basis of the flagellum. Types of the bacteria. Types of bacteria. The first type of bacteria is atrichous. Atrichous bacteria mein kya hoga? There will be no flagellum present. Theek hai? Bacteria do not have any type of the flagella. So no flagella is present on the atrichous type of bacteria. Example, micrococcus. Coccus bacteria jitne bhi honge wahan pe kya hota hai, maine pehle bhi bataya ki flagella hamesha absent hota hai. Jitne bhi coccus bacteria honge wo wahan pe flagella absent rahega. So example is micrococcus. Second type of bacteria is monotrichous. Mono means single, trichous means flagella. So, yahan pe hoga, there will be single flagella present on the one side of the body of the organism. Is tarike se hoga monotrichous. Mano ye bacteria hai, to iske sirf ek side mein ek single flagella present rahega. Theek hai? तो इसका एग्जाम्पल यू कैन साइ आई कैन राइट हियर इज विब्रियो एंड द अनदर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन राइट थायोबैसिलस नेक्स्ट इज एम्फीट्राइकस थर्ड टाइप इज एम्फीट्राइकस में क्या होता है फ्लैजला इज प्रेजेंट सिंगल फ्लैजलम इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द बोथ साइड ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑफ द बैक्टीरियल बॉडी ऑफ द बैक्टीरियल सेल फ्लैजला द टर्म फ्लैजला इज द प्लूरल फॉर्म एंड द सिंगुलर फॉर्म ऑफ फ्लैजला इज फ्लैजलम सो इन दिस केस वी विल यूज द टर्म फ्लैजलम हेयर ऑल्सो वी विल यूज द टर्म फ्लैजलम बिकॉज ऑन द बॉडी Suppose this is the bacteria's body, single flagellum is present on both the side, right? You can write down the example, nitrosomonas, ठीक है? Next type of bacteria is cephalotrichus, fourth one is cephalotrichus. सिफेलोट्राइकस में क्या होगा, वन बंच ऑफ बैक्टीरिया विल बी प्रेजेंट ओनली ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द बॉडी. सपोज दिस इज द बॉडी ऑफ द, दिस इज द बैक्टीरियल सेल एंड द बंच ऑफ फ्लैजला विल बी प्रेजेंट ओनली वन साइड. फॉर एग्जाम्पल कॉरिने बैक्टीरियम, कॉरिने बैक्टीरियम. नेक्स्ट इज लोफोट्राइकस. लोफोट्राइकस इन दिस केस द बंच ऑफ फ्लैजला इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द टू पोल और द टू साइड्स ऑफ द बॉडी और द सेल लाइक दिस. एक बंच एक साइड में है, दूसरा बंच दूसरे साइड में. सच टाइप ऑफ बैक्टीरिया आर नोन एज लोफोट्राइकस. एग्जाम्पल साल्मोनेला. लास्ट इज पेरिट्राइकस. इन दिस टाइप द होल सेल इज सराउंडेड बाय द फ्लैजला. ठीक है, द होल बॉडी ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया इज सराउंडेड बाय द इस तरह से फ्लैजला प्रेजेंट रहेगा. एग्जाम्पल ई कोलाई एंड साल्मोनेला टाइफी. ई कोलाई एंड साल्मोनेला टाइफी इट इज द कॉजल ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑफ द डिजीज टाइफॉइड. राइट, अब इनमें से दिस बैक्टीरिया पेरिट्राइकस दे आर पोलर बैक्टीरिया एंड द मोनोट्राइकस एम्फीट्राइकस सिफेलोट्राइकस एंड लोफोट्राइकस दे आर polar bacteria, sorry, and peritrichus is non-polar because they are present only मतलब distinct position is present there of the distinct position of the flagella is present there, whereas the here in this case flagella is present all over the body. So these are the types of the bacteria on the basis of the flagella. Now let's see the structure of flagellum. Flagellum are, as we know, that they are the protoplasmic growth which are present in numerous bacteria for swimming in the aquatic medium. So some flagella are there which contains the antigenic property. For example, in the case of bacteria Salmonella. Okay, in Salmonella, flagellum contains the antigenic property. Now this is the structure of bacterium flagellum of gram negative bacteria. Gram negative bacteria इसलिए बताया, ये मैं specially mention किया है क्योंकि here in this structure you can see there are four rings, right? यहाँ पे चार ring है. In case of gram positive bacteria only two rings are present. So we will discuss it just in few minutes. So first of all, I would like to tell you that फ्लैजला इज बेसिकली इन मेनली डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स. फ्लैजला जो होता है इट इज मेनली डिवाइडेड इनटू थ्री पार्ट्स. बेसल बॉडी, हुक. बेसल बॉडी, हुक एंड शेफ्ट और फिलामेंट. फिलामेंट विच इज ऑल्सो नोन एज शेफ्ट. फ्लैजलम की लेंथ इट वेरीज फ्रॉम 3 to 12 माइक्रोन. इन केस ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इसकी जो लेंथ होती है इट इज बिटवीन 3 to 12 माइक्रोन एंड इट्स विथ इज 12 to 18 nanometer. Right, now this basal body, it is mainly made up of rods and the rings. Right, so there are four rings are present. Basal body is mainly made up of rings and rods अब जो रिंग्स होती हैं, रिंग्स में भी इन सम केसेस वन पेयर ऑफ रिंग प्रेजेंट एंड इन द अदर केस द टू पेयर ऑफ रिंग्स प्रेजेंट. तो इन केस ऑफ वन पेयर ऑफ इन केस ऑफ ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया वन पेयर ऑफ रिंग्स आर प्रेजेंट. वन पेयर ऑफ रिंग्स प्रेजेंट इन ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया. बट लेट्स सी what are those rings. This is the L ring, this is L ring, this is P, S and M ring, right? And these are the rods, these are rods. Now these two rings they are present in the cell wall. ये दो रिंग जो हैं, दे आर अटैच्ड विद द सेल वॉल एंड दीज टू रिंग्स एस एंड एम दे आर अटैच्ड विद द प्लाज्मा लेमा और प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो देर आर टोटल फोर रिंग्स एल पी एस एंड एम. आउट ऑफ दीज फोर रिंग्स इन ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया ओनली टू रिंग्स आर प्रेजेंट. दे आर प्रेजेंट इन द इन देयर प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन, राइट. इन केस ऑफ ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया टू पेयर्स ऑफ रिंग्स आर प्रेजेंट. टू पेयर्स ऑफ रिंग्स प्रेजेंट इन ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया, ठीक है. तो ये जो एल एन पी लेट साइड देयर नेम कौन कौन सा रिंग्स है. इनमें होगा एल एस ग्राम पॉजिटिव बैक्टीरिया में एस एंड एम रिंग प्रेजेंट रहेगा, ठीक है. और ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया में एल पी एस एंड एम ऑल द फोर टाइप्स ऑफ द रिंग्स आर प्रेजेंट. एस एंड एम रिंग दे आर अटैच्ड विद प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. दीज रिंग्स आर अटैच्ड विद प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन, राइट. एंड दीज फोर रिंग हेयर इन दिस केस द एल एंड पी इन केस ऑफ ग्राम नेगेटिव बैक्टीरिया दीज एल एंड पी दीज रिंग्स आर अटैच्ड विद द सेल वॉल, ठीक है. नाउ just outside the cell wall there is a bent and thicker structure present. Bent and the thicker part of the flagella which is known as the hook. So hook is the, you can say that it is the bent and thicker part of flagellum. Present outside सेल वॉल, ठीक है. अब इसकी जो अगर हम लेंथ देखें तो इट इज अबाउट इट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 40 लेंथ इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 45 नैनोमीटर. इट इज 45 नैनोमीटर लॉन्ग एंड दिस इज हुक, राइट. And these are rings. Now this portion is known as shaft or filament. ठीक है, shaft or filament. Now filament is a narrow canal-like structure. It is empty inside. अगर हम इसको cut करेंगे ना, अगर आप इसको यहां से cut करते हो तो अंदर क्या होगा, इट इज एम्प्टी. एन एम्प्टी एरिया इज सराउंडेड बाय द वॉल ओनली, ठीक है. और जो वॉल होती है दैट इज दैट वॉल इस तरीके से रहेगा. मान लो ये हमने कट किया एंड देयर इज एन एम्प्टी एरिया, दिस इज द एम्प्टी एरिया, ठीक है. तो ये पूरा अंदर खाली रहेगा एंड दिस इज द वॉल. दिस वॉल इज मेड अप ऑफ फ्लैजलिंग प्रोटीन. 3 to 8 rows of flagellin proteins are present in this wall. आप समझ रहे हो ना, एक hollow tube है. Hollow tube is surrounded by that tube is surrounded by the membrane and that membrane is made up of the flagellin protein. So filament or shaft is a narrow canal like structure. ठीक है, and It is surrounded by, this empty space is surrounded by 3 to 8 spiral rows of flagellin protein. Okay? So, iski jo surrounded by this canal-like structure is surrounded by 3 to 8 rows of 3 to 8 spiral rows of flagellin protein. ठीक है, अब इन केस ऑफ बैक्टीरिया, जैसे कि हमने यूकैरियोटिक सेल में, सेल टॉपिक सेल में हमने पढ़ा कि जो यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स होते हैं उनमें जो फ्लैजेला होता है, देयर हैव 11 स्ट्रैंडेड, मींस देयर आर 9 प्लस 2 अरेंजमेंट इज प्रेजेंट. बट इन केस ऑफ प्रोकैरियोटिक फ्लैजेला इट इज यूनि स्ट्रैंडेड, 9 प्लस 2 अरेंजमेंट इज टोटली एब्सेंट, राइट. तो द बैक्टीरियल फ्लैजेला इज यूनि स्ट्रैंडेड, सिंगल स्ट्रैंड रहेगा, और वो भी क्या है, इट इज अ नैरो कैनाल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर, और जो कि एक एनवलप से कवर्ड है, विच इज मेड अप ऑफ 3 to 8 रोज ऑफ द स्पाइरल रोज ऑफ द फ्लैजेलिन प्रोटीन. सो दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ बैक्टीरियल फ्लैजेला. नाउ फ्लैजेला शोज द फ्लैजेलर मूवमेंट. इसमें क्या होगा, सेफ्टेड जो शैफ्ट होता है, इट रोटेट्स. सेफ्ट कैसे रोटेट होता है, देर आर टू वेज डिस्क्राइब बाय द वेरियस साइंटिस्ट. अकॉर्डिंग टू सम द शैफ्ट, दिस द होल फ्लैजेला और बेसिकली दिस शैफ्ट, इट रोटेट्स व्हेन दिस एम रिंग रोटेट्स. एम स्टैंड्स फॉर द मोटर, दिस एम स्टैंड्स फॉर द मोटर. तो जब ये एम रिंग रोटेट होगी 360 डिग्री पे, ठीक है, 360 जैसे हेलीकॉप्टर का ब्लेड घूमता है ना 360 डिग्री पे, तो उस तरीके से ही 360 डिग्री पे जब ये रोटेट होगा तो क्या होगा, ये रोटेट हो रहा है तो ये अपने साथ ये अटैच्ड है, सारे रिंग्स से अटैच्ड है, फिर हुक, उसके बाद शैफ्ट, तो ये सारे दूसरे रिंग्स भी रोटेट करेंगे उसी तरीके से 360 डिग्री पे, एंड देन दे विल कॉज द रोटेशन ऑफ दिस पोर्शन शैफ्ट द फिलामेंट. ठीक है, अकॉर्डिंग टू सम साइंटिस्ट दिस रोटेशन इज, यू कैन राइट द फ्लैजेला रोटेशन, इट शैफ्ट रोटेट्स ड्यू टू द रोटेशन इन द फ्लैजेलर बेस और इन द रोटेशन इन द एम रिंग. हियर वी कैन राइट शैफ्ट rotates due to rotation in the flagellar base that is 360 degree rotation in M ring. बट दूसरे साइंटिस्ट के हिसाब से दिस रोटेशन इज ड्यू टू द हेलिकल क्वाइलिंग ऑफ द फ्लैजेलिन मॉलिक्यूल्स, राइट. अकॉर्डिंग टू अदर साइंटिस्ट इट इज ऑल्सो ड्यू टू द हेलिकल क्वाइलिंग ऑफ फ्लैजेलिन मॉलिक्यूल्स. जो ये फ्लैजेलिन मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं, प्रोटीन्स, दे आर अरेंज्ड इन 3 to 8 स्पाइरल रोज, एंड ड्यू टू दिस हेलिकल और स्पाइरल क्वाइलिंग इट कॉजेज द रोटेशन इन द शैफ्ट ऑफ द फ्लैजेला. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द फ्लैजेला एंड द फ्लैजेलर मूवमेंट, फ्लैजेलर रोटेशन. थैंक यू.